In this video, we'll be checking out what smart controls can do for our guitars in Logic Pro 10. Hi guys, you're in the studio with Luke from guitariq.com. Thank you so much for sitting in with me on this video. We're here again looking at some of the new features of Logic Pro 10 and how they might be useful to those of us out there who are guitar players. So we've already looked at the new additions to Amp Designer and Pedal Board. We've looked at creating a track stack as a submix for these examples we've been working with. And now we're going to look at using smart controls with our guitar tracks. If you come up here to the control bar, you can see this button brings up an interface for our smart controls. Now, smart controls can manipulate multiple elements within a selected channel strip at once, or in this case, multiple elements within an entire track stack. So the first thing to note here is that Logic brings up some default parameter settings for our smart controls depending on the channel strip we have selected. In this case, because we have our track stack selected, we have controls here for our compressor and EQ plugins. If we bring them up, you'll see that we can switch these on and off. We can adjust various parameters within these plugins. And if I play the track, you'll see that this occurs in real time. So straight away, you can see that this could be pretty useful. But for me, the real power of smart controls comes when we start getting a little bit more creative in how we choose to customize our settings. So this icon here on the left gives us access to a whole lot of options for our smart controls. We can choose a whole lot of different templates to use. We can map our controls out to an external control surface if we want, and we can adjust all the parameters that our controls are actually themselves adjusting. So in this case, say I'm not all that concerned about being able to access my compressor from my smart controls, I can simply delete that plugin, and now all of these are currently unmapped. If this were a real mix situation, the first thing I might want to do is just have a master volume for this submix from my smart control. So I click on the control there, I select learn, and then I come over and select the fader that I want to adjust. Okay, and you can see how that's working there. If I then set that back to zero. The second thing I might think about doing is having a little bit more control over how wet or dry my guitars are sounding. I've got a bit of reverb and delay happening here. It's sounding a little bit washy. That may or may not be what I want in my final mix. Either way, I think that's something I want control over. So again, I'll repeat that process. Click on the unmapped parameter and there we go. Now I can actually relabel that to room. Okay. And now if I play that, you can see we can adjust that really easily. So the next thing I might think about doing is being a little bit more creative here with our smart controls. I'm thinking I want to be able to adjust the gain on my guitar amps. Now I say amps because I'm thinking about doing this for the left and right side of my rhythm track. But I want to do this from the same control over here. So instead of using this learn function, I'm going to actually use this drop down menu. Click here where it says unmapped. Now you can see we can access all of the different tracks within this track stack. Here I'm going to click on guitar left gain, and that's mapped out our gain. Now I want to map the right side to that same control. So I can just come here, click on add mapping, repeat the process for the right side. And now I actually have both amplifiers mapped to the same control here. If I just click on these and bring them up, now I can play the track and you can have a listen. So you can really start to see how useful this feature could potentially be when it comes to mix our tracks. We can control so many different parameters from this one simple interface. Now, let's really try and push this idea to the extreme and do something a whole lot more creative with these controls. For this last example, you can see again we have this guitar submix here, except that I've stripped it back to just the left and right rhythm tracks. I've then assigned smart controls to this track stack, and as you can see, in Logic Pro 10, we can assign up to 12 different controls using this smart control system. In this first section here, I again have the main volume mapped out here. I've mapped out the panning here. In this situation, that's not something I would use because I've got my guitar's pan hard left and hard right, but you could see how that would be helpful in a different situation. Again, I have my room or reverb send mapped out here and the delay send mapped out here. It's this section which really starts to make things quite interesting. If I bring up our Amp Designer plugin over here, you can see from this control here, I now have an independent control over the different amp heads. From here, I can control the different speaker cabinets. Down here, I can control my microphone type. And here, I can control the gain setting on the amp. But this is just for the left side. I've mapped this out to the right side independently also. From this simple little smart control interface, we can begin to control an amazing amount of information. So now let's have a play with this and see what it sounds like. So there you have smart controls in Logic Pro 10. Obviously, that was just a quick play around with some of these settings, but it definitely gives you the general idea of how you could set this up for yourself and the different ways you could use this feature in your own music. There's a lot of potential here. It really depends on how interesting and creative you want to get with these settings and how you want to structure your own workflow. As I mentioned, this can all be mapped out to external controls, which a lot of people are going to find useful. And secondly, it's worth noting that these controls can be used with automation as well. So if we want specific controls to transition at different points of our tracks, we can set that up automatically. Again, a really useful feature. A lot of really interesting stuff here, that is using smart controls on our guitars in Logic Pro 10. Well, that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. I'd really love to hear how you guys are using some of these new features in Logic Pro with your guitars when you're tracking and mixing. If you're interested in more content like this, then please check us out at the website, guitariq.com. While you're there, jump on board our mailing list. You can also check us out at Facebook. Like the page, leave some questions and comments for further videos. And lastly, if this video has helped you out today, please show some support for the channel by clicking on the like button, sharing the video with your friends, leaving a comment, and most importantly, subscribing to the channel. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video.